to spend his whole time in Krishna consciousness, to teach the as Vasudeva Maharaj, Krishna is his son, and he is asking from Narada, how I can evoke from this
world.
So we had discussed.
那么当时的话，卡德玛吉就问到了，当时的话呢，卡德玛尼的话呢，他呢的儿子哈，卡皮拉杰什么，为什么他在他出生之后呢，要离开家庭？那么师傅就讲到了，他是为了哈教导众生的，在人生之中的话，我们要呢，就是说不要依附哈，要弃绝呢这个呢，世俗的家居生活，而把时间花在呢，Krishna自己之中。
We should take lesson from Devahuti that how he heard pure bhakti yoga from Kapil Dev and then he was totally engaged in serving of Supreme Lord. She was looking as a mad woman. No eating, no drinking, no, she had no
awareness
of whether she has wrapped him with cloth or not, whether a stool and urine pass is going or not. Always absorbed in Krishna. So if you will follow this Devahuti and be totally immersed in Krishna consciousness, your life will be successful. Not for women, also for males, also same teaching. We have discussed about Uttama Bhakti. That is the no worldly desires in this world. All the activities of body, mind and tongue and everything should be engaged in Krishna. To please whatever you should do, to please Krishna. But if you are engaged in devotion of Krishna. And if you have any worldly desire, then it is not your bhakti. In this regard, in Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami is discussing about the Dhruva Charitra, how Dhruva in childhood, he left everything and how he worshipped Krishna and he took darshan. You should speak something. In brief.
So, now, this is talking about Devahuti, just now talking about Devahuti's this teaching. Talking about how he from his son, Kapila Dev, from the listening teaching, finally, completely serving the Supreme Lord. 外在的变成了众生。 疯狂的女人呢，不知不觉，连任何的身体概念，那么身上有没有穿衣服也不知道了，那么有没有拉屎拉尿也不知道，所以他完全呢，没有这种身体的概念，专注于呢，追寻的这个呢，他这个在一起的这个教导，而专注于呢，不舍自觉，那么这个教导不仅对于女性而言，那么对于男性这个修行者呢也如此，那我们讨论了乌特曼巴提。 那么乌藏巴提的指的是没有任何的世俗欲望，以身口意完全专注于 Krishna， 一切所做为了取悦 Krishna。 那么当你没有任何世俗欲望的时候，如果你还有任何世俗欲望贪感其中， 那么就不是呢哈，乌通旺巴提就是顶尖的这种哈，纯粹的这个奉献服务。
ॐ ज्ञानसिंहस्य अभिनन्दनशलाकया चक्षुः मिलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरवे गुरुसिंहाय राधिकाय सदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय सद्भक्ताय नमो नमः वंशकल्पतरुभ्यः कृतसिन्धुभ्यः पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः So Gurudev has ordered me to say something briefly about the Dhruva Charitra, the story of Dhruva, which is a story in the Srimad Bhagavatam that teaches us a lot about gives us some lessons on how to develop our devotion and also some lessons about what not to do.
那么呢，徐德贵呢，在我们讲授哈，卢瓦大清的这个教导，我们这个教导里面讲到了哈，如何呢去从事呢哈奉献服务，还有呢如何避免一些哈不应该做的事情。
So Dhruva was a little boy.And his mother was the co-wife of King Uttanapad, and the other wife was the favorite queen of the of King Uttanapad.
那么他的母亲的话呢，卢瓦大清的母亲哈是呢国王呢一个妃子哈，那么他并不是呢哈这个国王最宠爱的妃子之一。
Okay, his mother's name was.Su Rishi.
那么他的母亲是Suniti哈，他的母亲。
The other queen's name was Suniti. Su Rishi.
Su Rishi 哈是他另外一个王妃的名字。
So one day, when the king was sitting there, the son of the king, Su Rishi's son, went and sat on the king's on Uttanapad's lap.So when Dhruva saw this, he also naturally came and wanted to sit on the king's other lap.
那么呢哈，有一天的话呢，他的另外一个母亲哈，徐启的这个儿子哈，是他的兄弟的，坐在他父亲的这个腿上。那么他也很自然的哈，卢瓦大清的话也想哈坐在父亲的这个腿上。
But when Suruchi saw that Suniti's son is sitting on Uttanapad's lap, she became envious.And she told him, she chastised him, said, only you cannot sit on the king's lap, because I'm the favorite wife, I'm the favorite queen. And only when you take birth next lifetime, from my womb, then you can sit on the king's lap.
那么当时呢，这个王妃呢，扶起的话呢，就看到古尔大勋坐在他的父亲这个腿上，他就很嫉妒了，他就说了，他说除非你再次出生，从我的胎里面出生。作为儿子的意思哈，就是说呢，你才能够坐在呢你父亲的这个腿上。
You see, even in the Bhagavatam, in the best families, there's some problems.
所以呢，在佛教法堂里面哈，在最好的家庭里面呢，也有这些问题哈。
This is material life. But we have some lessons to learn.
所以这就是物质的哈生活了，然后我们有些哈这个教法在其中。
When these words went like a knife into Dhruva Maharaj's heart, he was only a 5-year-old child. He was very much hurt and upset.
那么这些话的话，像那个刀子哈，插在呢杜瓦大勋的哈这个呢这个心上一样。虽然他只是个哈五岁大的小孩子。
And he went crying to his mother, Suniti, and he said, "I'm very upset. What can I do? How, you know, what should I do? I also want to sit on my father's lap."
那么当时呢，跑到他的母亲Suniti那里说了哈，他说呢，我很不高兴哈，我也想哈坐在我父亲的这个腿上。
I also want to be a king. Actually, I want to be a king greater than my father.
我也想成为一个王哈，也成为一个哈比我父亲更伟大的王。
And his father, King Uttanapad, was the king of the whole world. And Dhruva Maharaj was so hurt, he had the desire to be even greater than his father.
那么他父亲当时哈是整个世界的哈是世界之王了，但是呢当时哈卢瓦大清很受伤害了，他甚至有种欲望想比他的父亲拥有比他父亲。
Then his mother said, I don't have the solution to your problem, but I know one thing, that if you pray to Vishnu, to Lord Krishna, then he can fulfill all desires, so you should go and pray to him.
那么他的母亲孙女说哈，我没有呢解决的方法，但是如果你向主拿来啊祈祷的话呢哈，他能够解决你的问题。
So, Dhruva Maharaj said, but where can I find this Lord Narayan? Where can I find him? And Suniti said, oh, you should go, I heard that he's in the forest, so you should go to the forest and then you should meditate on him and do some austerity.
那么当时呢，他就询问他的母亲呢，他说呢，我在哪里能够找到祖拿拉呀？那他母亲说了哈，我也不知道哈，听说了哈，他呢在呢这个森林里面，所以你可以哈去到呢森林中哈做一些冥想。So
then he went to the forest and started meditating. 5 years old and he started doing some austerities and meditating.
那么他就去到呢森林里面了哈，就是才5岁那么大哈，开始呢做一些冥想打坐。
So he attracted the attention of Lord Narayan, who sent Narad Muni to him.
那么他呢吸引了哈祖拉雅，那么祖拉雅呢就把哈他的这个Narad Muni的话呢哈送到他面前了。
So Narad Muni is Jagat Guru, and he knew what's in Dhruva Maharaj's heart. So he came to him and he asked him, oh, you're only 5 years old, what are you doing in the forest? You should immediately go back to your mother, go back to the palace.
那么呢，Narad Muni也是呢，加个咕噜哈，宇宙之师了，所以他也明白哈，卓尔大君呢心中的所想，他就告诉他哈，你在这里干什么哈？你应该立即的哈，回家去，回到你父母身边。So
Narad Muni was only testing the determination of Dhruva, and Dhruva means fixed, someone is completely determined to get what he wants.
那这样呢，Narad Muni 哈想测试他心中哈这种的稳固，就说呢他心中有没有心意稳不稳固了。那么卓尔这个词的话呢，也是哈坚定不移的意思。
So Dhruva Maharaj said, no, I will not go back. I want to get darshan of Lord Narayan because I had some desire that I want to get. When I first came to Gurudev, I think after 10 years in Iskcon, I asked Gurudev, oh, would you give me shelter, would you give me your nurse? He said, no, you should go back to your guru.
Go back to your guru?
Yes.
那么当时哈，马老师的话呢，跟过来跟着这个，跟过来归队这边的时候呢，归队对他说，你应该回到你以前的部落那里去吗？So
he was only testing me, and I knew it, so I said, no, I'm not going back.
实际上哈，他也是在测试我哈，我就说了哈，我不会回去了。So
then Narad Muni gave him mantra.
所以 Narad Muni 当时哈，享受他曼陀罗。
And the lesson is that without receiving mantra from a bona fide guru, from a real guru, in Uttam Bhagavat Guru, a pure devotee guru, we cannot really attain Krishna, we cannot attain darshan of Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate. So with this mantra, Guru Maharaj started meditating. And his medication was so strong, and his austerities were very, very severe. First he stopped eating, then he stopped drinking, then he even stopped breathing. He was standing on one leg and breathing only once in a while. His austerities were so severe that the whole universe began to shock.
一开始呢不吃的哈，后来不喝哈，希望呢不呼不吸啊，就是说单饱独立。那么他这种苦行的话呢，遇到哈放生人哈都呢，这个哈就这个呼吸难困难呢。
Then Lord Narayan appeared to him in his meditation, appeared to Dhruva in his meditation. Finally he saw Lord Narayan in his heart, he got spoon in his heart of Lord Narayan.
然后最后呢，祖拿雅在看到这个冥想中哈，想见了哈，这个菩提哈，就是一瞬间的这个想。And
immediately his meditation broke because Lord Narayan was so beautiful and so attractive that he could not remain in meditation anymore. He opened his eyes and he couldn't see Lord Narayan.
那么呢，这个这时候的话呢，哈，那么业主拿雅的话呢，哈，这个身体哈非常是呢，光胖哈，夺目了，所以他的影响呢，哈，就中断了，他打开眼睛哈，看不见了真主。
So then he started to cry, and Lord Narayan manifested to him directly.
他呢就开始哈哭起来哈，他请求了祖拿雅呢哈亲自呢显现。And
when he saw Lord Narayan, he uttered one shloka, "Sanabila shloka pasisti toham pram pram chanam krasan vishinvan api vidya ratnam swami kita tosi varam nayache." So Lord Narayan asked him, what do you want? And Dhruva Maharaj said in this shloka, I have performed austerities that are even difficult for the demigods, and you know, I can. But now that I've seen you and I got your darshan, my purpose is completely fulfilled, and I feel completely satisfied. So I don't want any benediction from you. I was looking for a piece of broken glass. I had a material desire to become the king of the whole world, greater than my father. But now that I've seen you, I have no more material desire.
大师兄，就最师尊主人拿来，就说了哈，当时他说我从事的苦行，甚至呢是放红的囊萤的做到的。当时呢，我见到得到你的帮选之后呢，我所有的愿望哈都已经满足了。我曾经渴望一个哈，就是说呢，比我这个祖先哈，我们还要呢伟大的王国。但是现在呢，我现在是这不过呢是呢哈，就是寻找的一个玻璃渣子。见到你的话呢，就像一个像石一样。
I was looking for a piece of broken glass. My material desire to be the greatest. We are all stuck in this material world because we want to be the most beautiful, the best teacher, you know, the best brahmachari, the best this. I want to be the most of something. We want to be God, we want to be Krishna, and that's why you're stuck here. So Dhruva said the same thing. You know, I had material desires, but now that I've got your darshan, these material desires are like this piece of broken glass, and your darshan is like a transcendental gem, like a transcendental diamond. So I had no desires now.
那么我们来到这个世界哈，都想呢成为哈最好的哈，最好的这个哈掌机者哈，最好的 brahmachari， 就是想寻求这些东西哈，想甚至想成为神啊。我们来到这个世界，那么图瓦大君也同样哈以这种欲望呢开始他的灵修的，他想成为最伟大的哈这个呢国王。 所以他呢就说了哈，我寻找的是一个破碎的玻璃渣子啊，但是的话呢，你的当选却像了哈一个呢尊贵的珠宝。现在我见到你哈，已经呢完全心满意足。But
then what Lord Narayana said, sorry, you have some material desires while you're doing your sadhana. So first, you will have to taste the fruit of your desires. You have to be the king of this planet Earth or the whole material universe for 36,000 years. And only then you can again associate with me directly.
He is the world. 那么这个时间呢过了后呢，你才能够去走，就另外一些东西。So
what is the lesson we have to we can take from this history of Dhruva Maharaj? We should take his determination, his absolute determination, to get his goal, and we should also have this fixed determination to attain Guru Nishtha.
那么的话呢，我们从图瓦大君这个故事里面哈，得到呢这个教导呢，就是说我们一定要有坚定的哈这个呢啊这个决心啊。
Because by Guru Nishtha, everything else will come.
因为急着 Guru Nishtha 哈，对 Guru 的坚定的信念的话，你一切呢哈都可以呢达成。But
what we should not take is we should not perform bhakti, should not do our sadhana and bhajan with material desires, because then we will have to take these material desires first before we can reach pure bhakti.
那么呢，第二个我们要不得的东西呢，就是说呢哈，你不要怀着呢哈这个呢物质欲望哈去从事呢你的这个发展呢你的修行，不然的话呢，你最后呢，首先要满足哈这个欲望，然后呢才能得到呢哈纯粹的东西的。So
Srila Gurudev said, be careful what you're thinking about and what you're desiring when you're chanting Hare Krishna and performing your sadhana, because if you're not careful, then you will have first to taste the result of your material desires, and then who knows how much time will be wasted.
所以呢，师父贵在哈，就警告了哈，警示我们了。他说你们哈，唱诵诵名或修行啊，做服务的时候，一定要小心你们的哈这个欲望哈念头啊，因为不然的话呢，你就要品尝这些东西啊，而这东西会浪费相当多的时间哦。其实你实现你的欲望，浪费很多时间。
Therefore, try to read Bhagavatam thoroughly.
something is wrong, what you do? You should see for me and me. So, at the time of doing bhajan, we should not desire anything. Otherwise, your bhakti will be sakam bhakti. Not pure bhakti. And thousands of bhakti will have to chase your desire. So, this would give up all of our desire. Second, if Bhuva at the age of 5, he can take the darshan of Supreme Lord. If Prahlad Maharaj at the age of 5, he can take the darshan of Nrisimhadev or Krishna. If Nachiketa can take darshan in a 5 years age, why we cannot make a object and aim of your life? I will do or die, but I will receive the darshan of Krishna and his son. And then go on practicing bhakti.
那么我们在修行，你们在修行在做发展的时候，应该是无欲无求的，不然的话，你们的奉爱福 bhakti 的话是呢，发空 bhakti 呢，也就是不纯粹的这个奉献服务。你千千万万事，你都要品尝你自己的这个欲望，所以我们在从事灵修的时候，一定要放弃所有的欲望。那么第二点，卢瓦大勋在五岁的时候，那么就能够觐见到呢主拿拉扬。普拉达大勋在五岁的时候呢，也能够觐见到呢尼西那给，还有那西给坦哈，也是五岁的时候呢就能够见到神。所以为什么我们不能呢？所以呢，我们要设定目标，要么做好，要么死，一定要能够去呢就是从事的。就一定要坚定的去从事呢对至尊主的这个呢服务。
Also, who has some desire at the time of departing? When an aeroplane came that you should go to
Vaikuntha planet,
she told that I don't want to go alone. I want to see that my mother should go with me. And that is why she could not go to Vaikuntha. She could not go to Golok Vrindavan. She went to Dhruva Lok, which is situated in the universe. To whom sun is rotating, that is Dhruva Lok. So we should be very careful that there should be no worldly desire in our people.
That is Madarova's
first person, Guru. Mother told you to be Bhajan. Anyhow, we never tell that my Gurudev should go. So, Gurudev, I want that my Gurudev should come.
那么这里面讲的哈，卢瓦大勋啊，当时哈要走的时候，要离开这个世界的时候，这个呢哈，临幸的这个飞机来的时候，他说我不想单独一个人走，我要我的母亲也一起走哈。那么就是因为呢这个欲望的话呢，他不能够去到白空港，不能够去到格罗克林丹。所以我们留下来哈，这个呢，这个物质宇宙物质世界里面，所以我们也要非常小心哈，我们的这个呢哈，这些欲望。
That is, but then we don't see any action there. Who is there? It may be Hari in any way. Not Krishna.
You should know that by self gratification, beautiful wife, beautiful husband, qualified children, anyone cannot be happy in this world. It should not be as self in this world. Otherwise, your life, thousands of life will be ruined. So, we should remember the history of Puranjan. And Damodar Maharaj will change in.
你们要知道，感官享受美丽的妻子和我英俊的丈夫，我有自责的儿子，这些东西呢，都是呢，是要不得的，没有利，不能够利你快乐的。所以呢，不要依附这东西，不然的话呢，千百万世呢，都会被毁掉。所以呢，我们要听见呢，普朗卷这个国王的这个故事。
Kārūtāya tadāle krishnāya krishnāvāsaya tadāvāsaya namāya namaha. First of all, I offer pranāms to Śrīla Gurudev, Śrīdhāndis, Sannyāsīs, Vaiṣṇavāchārīs, Vaiṣṇavas, Vaiṣṇavīs. Śrī Guru has given me instruction to hear the history of Puranjan. So he was also delivered from the ocean of material attachment by the mercy of Sri Narada Muni.
Given
Sri Narada Muni saved so many devotees from this world. There was one king, his name was Kashinabari. He was very much attached to Karma Kanda, the idea of after death I will go to the heavenly planets and enjoy material life there. Therefore, that was not in this age, but was in a previous age, they would sacrifice animals like horses, etc. But this is forbidden in Kali Yuga. There is no animal sacrifice in Kali Yuga. Therefore, Kashinabari was killing so many animals, then Narada Muni felt so much compassion for the king, because he was doing everything out of ignorance.
那么呢，这个国王哈，他去巴黎的话呢，他屠杀了相当多的这个动物，那么拿着木椅哈，为他呢感到呢哈非常的伤痛了哈，因为他出于愚昧这样做的。So
she not only told him a nice history that the king could understand his position.
因此呢，拿着木椅向他讲了一个很美妙的故事哈，让他呢明白他自己的这个身份的位置。
He said there was a man named Puranjana.
他是有一个人哈，叫呢 Puranjana。
Puranjana means the soul, Puranjana. He is the most ancient person, that is us. The soul within the body,
Puranjana.
He is moving everywhere looking for a good place to enjoy life. But everywhere he went, he found some dissatisfaction.
但是所到之处呢，都有些不满足的地方。
Then finally came to the south of the Himalaya, there was one country called Bharatvarsha, India.
那么呢，七号呢，我和七号呢，这个喜马拉雅山哈，这个南边，那么叫巴拉啊，这个地方印度了。
China is north of the Himalaya, but India is south of the Himalaya.
哦，中国呢属于呢哈喜马拉雅是北的，那么印度呢属于呢哈喜马拉雅是南。
Therefore, easy for Chinese to adopt Vedic culture because very close.
所以实际上呢哈，中国人呢一个地比较好的能够哈接受呢北达的传统，因为呢实际上很相近的。
There, Puranjana came to one city called Bhogavati.
那么呢，唐僧呢，哈，来到一个城市叫 Bhogavati 这个城市。
That was a very beautiful city.
这是一个非常美丽的城市。
It had 9 gates.
有九个门哈，城门。
There were parks, trees, rivers, wells, and houses.
嗯，有呢，这些哈，花园呐，哈，路道路啊，哈，房子啊，等等。
Some houses were made of gold, some were made of silver, some were made of copper.
那么有的东西的话是由金子做成的，有的是由银哈做成的，有的是铜。
The king was very happy in that city.
那么这个国王很高兴哈，在那城市待着。
That city represents this human body.
像这个城市代表的是我们哈的身体。
Because of all species of life, this human being is the topmost.
因为所有物种里面哈，以人生哈最为的哈是最高的。
Nideham adyam sulabam sudulabam.Of all species of life, this human body is the most precious.
所以在世界里面讲到哈，在所有的这个身体里面呢，以人生哈为最的珍贵。
Labam sukalpam guru kanadaram. This body is like a boat to cross the ocean of birth and death.
那么这身体的话呢，哈是跨越呢生死自然的哈这个船。
Therefore, we need a captain of that boat. That is the guru.
那么我们需要哈这个呢掌舵者哈这个船长，那么这就是呢哈 guru。
Maya Kulena Adulis Pratipa. That is, we need a breeze. That is the favorable instructions of the scriptures and the sadhus.
那我们需要一个圣像风哈，那么这就是呢哈一个沙土或是呢哈古鲁的这个训示。
Human Bhavidhi Natharit Sa'atmahan. One who does not take a proper use of this human form of life is a killer of their own soul.
如果一个人不善用这个人生的话呢哈，就是呢自己的哈这个灵魂的这个屠夫。
This body has 9 gates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 gates in this body. Is analogy is describing the human form of life.
那么河流的话呢，就是我们身体里面的哈这些呢血啊血管等等。那么这只是一个譬喻哈，就这个城市就像我们的身体一样。
This body is made of mucus, bile, and air. Therefore, it's made of two things.
Oh. 那么我们这身体哈，由呢这些哈就是阴液哈发等等哈这东西。
Then Puranjan came in that city. He was very happy.And he came to the park, which is the heart.
观者的话呢，哈，来到这个城市非常高兴啊，来到了哈这个呢公园，公园代表呢是我们的心。
In that park, he saw a very beautiful girl, very attractive.
那么在公园里面的话，看到一个呢非常美丽的哈
女孩。Yes, not working. Say again.
他找到了一个非常美丽的女孩。
Then who is that girl?She is the material intelligence.
那么这个哈，美丽的女孩子是什么哈？就是物质的智慧。
But I must first tell the story and then explain. Okay. So he fell in love with that girl.
他呢哈就爱上了这个女孩子。
Oh, I like you as my wife. We will live together.
他说哈，我想让你成为我的妻子哈，我们一起生活吧。
The king completely lost his intelligence in her association.
所以呢，这个国王哈，在他的这个女孩子的联姻之中的话，完全哈失去了他的智慧。
When the queen will eat, he will eat.
啊，他的哈妻子的哈，这个女王哈，东西的时候呢，他才吃。
That queen, she had 10-11 bodyguards.
那么这个妃子呢哈，有11个呢，这个哈保镖卫兵。
And she had hundreds of assistants.
还有呢哈，数以百计的这些呢哈，这个仆人。
Protecting her with a 5-headed snake.
啊，以五头蛇哈来保护她。
She had 2 breasts.
嗯，她有双乳哈。
This is all analogy described by Nada.
当然，这是一个哈譬喻来的。
The king became completely attached to her.
所以呢，这个国王希望呢，完全依恋这个这个女孩。
When she would eat, he would eat.
啊，他的妃子吃东西的时候，他才吃。
When she would drink, he would drink.
啊，他喝水的时候啊，这个国王才喝。
When she was happy, he was happy.
当这种王妃高兴的时候，他很高兴。
When she was sad, he was sad.
当他不高兴的时候，伤心的时候，他也伤心。
He would follow her everywhere.
追着她到处走。
He became completely enamored by sexual desire, and he forgot the passing of time.
也就是呢，他完全的就被这种色欲捆绑了而呢完全忘记了时间的流逝。
Then there was one king, his name was Chandravedh, or time.
那么呢，有另外一个国王叫 Chandravedh, 是时间的。
He sent his army with 360 soldiers, and each soldier had a wife.
那么他派了他的军队去360个士兵，每个士兵都有这个呢一个妻子。
Those 720 soldiers attacked the city of Puranjan.
所以这720人就是攻击了Puranjan这个城市。
Puranjan was fighting for a long time, for 100 years, until he became tired.
那普兰卷的话呢，就战斗了100年最后呢很累的。
Then one girl came. She said, "I want to marry you." Her name was Jada.
那么呢这时候有个女孩子过来说我想嫁给你，她的名字叫Jada。
And he was forced to accept her.
最后呢，他被迫答应了。
That girl had also gone to Narad Muni, but Narad Muni rejected her.
那么这个女孩子也去到Narad Muni但是呢却呢被圣人Narad呢拒绝了。
Because Narad Muni is a brahmachari, therefore old age can never touch him.
因为呢Narad Muni是呢brahmachari，所以老年不会触碰到他的，他不会变老。
Also, she had a brother. His name was Jada Siva.
那么这一个女孩子有一个兄弟呢叫呢Jada，就是说呢高潮Siva。
Old age means.Old age and fever.
也就是老年和呢这个发烧了，就是病了
That's water. Therefore, these all were attacking the king.
所以这些东西都来攻击这个国王。
Then the five-headed snake became weak.
这个五头蛇变得很虚弱。
Everyone began running out of the city of Puranjan, which was burning.
每个人的话都从 Puranjan 国王这个城市里面逃脱了，因为这里的已经着火了。
At the time of death, Puranjan thought of his wife, therefore he took birth as a woman.
那么在普兰卷在死亡之时呢，想着他的妻子，所以呢，他最后投胎为女生了。
She was very beautiful.
然后她呢很漂亮。
She had eyes which were black like ointment. What's it called? Mascara.
那么她眼睛画上这个眼线，黑色的眼线。
She had the good fortune of marrying a great king called Malayadwaj.
那么那一辈子里面她呢很幸运就嫁给了一个国王。
And she served Malayadwaj very faithfully.
那么她以非常大的信心服务这个国王Malayadwaj.
All this time, Kashyap Puranjan had a friend called Abhijata, the unknown one, but he could not understand that was his friend.
那么在所有这些时间里面这个呢 ，Puranjan 都有一个不知道的一个朋友在陪伴着他。
Therefore, after some time, Malayadwaj, the king, he went to the forest to perform austerities, and the girl went there and served him faithfully.
那么呢过了段时间呢这个国王就是他丈夫了去到森林里面去苦修了那么他也一同随去呢充满信心的服侍他
After some time Malayadwaj left this world and that girl was weeping bitterly
那么这国王后来离开了这个世界那么这个孩子女孩子呢在那里痛苦的这个哭泣
She was going to burn her husband and jump on the same funeral fire when one Brahmin came that Brahmin was the unknown friend in disguise
那么当时她为她丈夫举行这个葬礼的时候呢，想跳进她的这个火里面想寻葬的。那么这时候一个婆罗门呢，就假装成婆罗门的这个不知情的这个朋友呢，就过来了。
Oh, he said, "You have forgotten me."
他说你忘了我。
We are like two swans on a lake, very intimate. But you have forgotten me, therefore you are suffering.
Two
swans.
Swan in a lake. 那么我们像一个池塘里面的两只天鹅。但是你忘了我。
So Narad Muni told this whole story to Kashyapabali. He could not understand.
所以呢，Narad Muni像呢Kashyapabali的话呢，讲了整个故事但是呢，他不明白。
Therefore, Puranjan means the soul.
Puranjan 是指灵魂的意思。
He moves to the 8,400,000 species of life, but cannot find happiness.
他游历840,000种的这个身体但是呢，却找不到真正的快乐。
Then by good fortune, he gets the chance to reside in the human form of life.
没有急着幸运他可能得到人生居住在人生这身上。
Of 9 gates.
这个人的身体有9个门。
With many coverings, many things.
有很多覆盖。
So there he met the material intelligence.
那么在那里的话呢，他遇遭遇到了哈，物质的哈，这个自己。That
is a beautiful girl.
那就是那个美丽的女孩子。Because
in this world we fulfill our desires by the means of our material intelligence.
因为呢，我们在这个世界呢，实现我们的欲望呢，是通过我们的物质的哈，智慧。Now
the soul is almost sleeping and being controlled by the mind, which is controlled by the intelligence.
那么的话呢，哈，像这时候呢，灵魂已经睡着了哈，被呢心意哈所控制，而心意呢哈也受到了物质智慧的这个控制。
Therefore, the soul forgets his position as being the master of the mind and senses. He becomes controlled by the mind and senses.
因此呢，这个哈国王的话呢，忘记了他是呢感官和心意的主人哈，而呢深受感官和心意的这个呢控制。
She had 11 bodyguards, means along with the intelligence, her 11 servants are the senses.
那么呢哈，这个女王，这个妃子呢有11个哈守卫，那么意味着哈在心意之外呢，她还有11种感官。
Seeing, smelling, tasting, hearing, touching.
就是呢哈，这个嗅觉哈，还有呢视觉、触觉等等。
Speech.
还有言辞哈。
Digestion.
消化。
Moving.
行走的能力。
The genitals and the rectum.
还有呢，就是说呢哈，这个呢前因后效。
Plus the mind.
还有心意等等。
These are 11 bodyguards.
可以成为呢11个哈这个呢卫兵。
These bodyguards have millions and millions of. These senses have millions and millions of servants, which are like thousands of desires we have, millions of material desires.
那么这些哈，十一个卫兵哈，这十一种感官的话呢，有无数的哈，这个呢，这个哈，服从的，那服从就是我们的物质欲望。
The five headed snake is the life air, five life airs in our body.
那么五头蛇的话，就是呢，我们的5种哈生命之气啊体内的。
The soul gets this package deal and thinks I will be happy by this.
那么像灵魂那样去以为哈，就是说呢，这些东西哈，我能够快乐哈，得到这些东西我能快乐。但是呢哈，他却受深受时间的这个攻击。
She is attacked by time in the form of old age.
他时间呢哈也老年呢哈来攻击他。And the time of death we get a great fever that comes also. 那么的话，在呢死亡之时啊，我们会发牢骚哈，这也会来的。
360 days, 360 nights, 720 soldiers attacking the body.
所以的话呢哈，365天哈，365个月啊，日夜晚，那么就是说700多个的哈，这个哈攻击。
Krishna says, whatever we think of the time of death, that is your next body, your next destination.
所以呢 ，Krishna 说哈，你死亡之时所思所想的，就是你的哈来世的这个目的地。
Therefore, the king he took birth as a woman.
其实呢，这个国王哈，来世呢投胎为一个哈女生的。
But she was lucky because she had some desire for devotion.
那么她很幸运的哈，因为她有一些呢服务的欲望。
Therefore, she got the chance to get a great husband as a devotee, means a spiritual master.
那么就是呢哈，她得到了哈一个呢伟大的奉献者作为她丈夫，就是灵性导师。
Malaya Dwaj, because from the Malaya Mountains, a very sweet smell comes of sandalwood that's very cooling and keeps away the heat of the summer.
那么马来西亚哈，这个地方的话呢，据说它来自喜马拉雅的檀香哈，令到呢这个哈，就是身体很舒缓。
She served that spiritual master perfectly, like a faithful wife. You should do like that also.
那么像一个有信心的妻子，这样服侍这个灵性导师，我们也应该这样做。
Also, a mountain is very strong, therefore the bona fide spiritual master is very, very thick, very heavy.
那么的话呢，就像山一样非常的这个坚固很强壮。那么一个真正灵性导师也是这样子的。
Therefore, as long as the spiritual master is present as well, the disciple must serve very faithfully.
所以只要呢哈，灵性老师在世的话呢哈，门徒一定要哈非常的充满信心哈，服务他。
And when the spiritual master leaves, then the disciple must weep bitterly.
那么如果哈灵性老师隐居的话呢哈，一个门徒哈要呢就是说呢要哭哈，痛苦的去哭。
By the grace of the guru, one can meet the unknown friend or Krishna in the heart.
那么提着孤独的仁慈哈，一个人呢，弟子能够遇到哈那个他不知道的朋友，那就是他心中的哈这个主。
In the heart is truth, the soul and the super soul.
那心中有两个人哈，一个是个体灵魂，一个是超灵。Both
are together in the lake of the heart.
两个人哈都在呢这个哈心里面。So
hearing all this, Krishna body became conscious. Oh, I am wasting my human form of life in materialistic endeavor.
所以的话呢，听了这些东西的话呢，他听了巴里的话哈，他就觉悟过来哈，说呢我浪费了哈我的时间在这物质生活里面。
So by the grace of Narada Muni, he gave up his materialistic religious activities and adopted the path of pure devotion. Sri Narada Muni ji. Gopamanandu.
Jamin Upakshan and Chitraketu Upakshan, Yasushi and Giri. Today our class is finished. He will be part of us.
Once again, announcement. Tomorrow morning at 7:30, Shripad Bhaktananda Madhav Maharaj will give class. And then at 10 o'clock, Shripad Bhaktananda Damodar Maharaj will give class.
10 o'clock.
Okay, tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock there will be Darshan, the Shubha Day's residents, devotees from the Philippines and different parts of the world will meet with him tomorrow and the day after that. The rest of the devotees from China can meet the Shubha Guru Day's.
明天的话是呢，这个北京和其他世界其他婚姻的这个大选，是建国的，然后后天的话是所有剩下来的很多国的奉献者，然后这个大选，还有香港的奉献者可能也包括。And
the Hong Kong devotees will be done the day after tomorrow.
啊，也是后啊，香港婚姻者也是后天哈。